This unit is mostly about first-order differential equations, but I should point out that second-order differential equations come up a lot in physics and electrical engineering. Not quite so much in biology and economics, but a lot in physics and electrical engineering. So here's an example of a system that's modeled by a second-order equation. We've got a mass, m, connected to a spring, spring constant k, and we just take the mass and we pull it over to the side and we let go and watch it bounce back and forth and back and forth. What kind of equation governs its motion? Well, Hooke's law says that the force from a spring is proportional to how much you stretch the spring, and it's pulling back towards the center. So if x is positive, you pull it out to the right, the spring is pulling things back to the left, so it's minus a constant times x. And Newton's law says that force equals mass times acceleration. And remember, acceleration isn't the derivative of position, it's the second derivative of position. So if you put these two rules together, you get that the mass times the second derivative of the position is minus k times the position, where k is some constant. Or to put it another way, the second derivative of position is minus k over m, that's a constant, times the position itself. Second order equation. So let's check out some numbers. Let's just check out the numbers, what happens if k is 12 and m equals 3. And in that case, k over m is 4. So we wind up with the equation, the second derivative is minus 4 times x. Now, you can check that sine of 2x is a solution to that, because the derivative of sine of 2x is twice cosine, and the derivative of that is negative 4 sine, and that's minus 4x. You can also check that cosine of 2t is also a solution, because the derivative of that is minus 2 sine of 2t, and the derivative of that is negative 4 cosine of 2t, and that's minus 4x. So put that together, and actually, there are lots of solutions that depend on not just one constant, but two constants. When we saw exponential growth, there was one constant. It was a e to the kt. Here we have a constant times sine plus a second constant times cosine. That's what you tend to get from second-order systems, and it means that you don't need one piece of initial data to say where things are going. You need two pieces of initial data. It's not enough to say what the initial position of the block is. You have to give the initial position of the block and the initial velocity of the block. Once you do that, you can figure out what C1 and C2 are. Once you do that, you know where the block will be for all time. So because of F equals MA, lots and lots of physics problems boil down to second-order systems of differential equations. And the same thing goes for electrical engineering.